Hi, my name is Rodney Burkoff, and this is a tale of my life. Because I've ruined it and have been in jail for over 20 years of it. Because of random murder, robbing casinos, sex with random whores, and some other things that you're about to witness in the life of Rodney Burkoff. This is me when I was younger, when I was wearing the chicken suit, and was much taller. I shrank over the years, it would seem, but not in one place. But besides that, I was crack smoking addict who loved to go to strip clubs and have sex with hookers, as you can see. This is Liz. We loved to dance together in the club. It was so much fun, and she was a foreigner too who came to San Andreas to look to better herself in many ways she could. At this point, I was very drunk in the club, and she was back at the bartending stool, and I told her to come to my place so we can have a good time, and she accepted it. So then we left. I tell her to follow me in her car because she didn't want to get on back of a scooter. I tell her it's small and she has a fast fucking bullet right there, so then she follows me to my house. Finally, we arrived to my house, which is a very nice one indeed. I went to the door to unlock it real fast, then to let her in behind me. When she got in the house, we went upstairs, because that's where my bedroom is, and you know what happens in the bedroom. But as I looked back, and I thought, I'm about to have sex with a very hot woman. Nice. As we're sitting in my bed, she offers me sex, so I accepted it. I mean, who wouldn't accept it? You'd have to be a fool. After that, I had to go to work. While I was sitting at work, I was just thinking, why do I work at the fucking clucking bell with a shirt that says, taste my cock? So I decided to take my sonoffs and revolt out of the fucking place. I then hopped on my clucking bell bike and fucking rode off to the fucking bank. And there I started to wonder, should I rob this shit? Or should I just go here and deposit my money I made from work today? But I already revolted out of my house with for this part, why wouldn't I rob the bank? I mean, it's a lot of money if I get done with it, you know? So I decided to rob it. And yeah, that's how it's going down. Yes, so the bank rob is working so far. I'm cracking the safe. Oh, what a very glorious day for me. Let's hope it works. That's how I remember it, and it did, but at first I didn't think it was going to. So I put my sonos to make sure to look around for any sign of cops or civilian to kill. Success! We got the safe, now we run out. Holy shit, there's two cops! And after this point, when I got onto my bicycle, this is the song I heard. I started to go to my house to have a shootout with a police officer. This was the first time I was arrested in San Andreas, but it was okay, I was only arrested for a couple days. And I also met a very wise man named Demo Spider-Man in here. But he was very brutally killed by Fist, and I was shot in the shoulder by a cop. I still have the bullet there. The doctor said if I have it taken out surgically, I can die from it, so I'll just leave it. So I was sitting in my house one day when my girlfriend called, so I went to pick her up. I had an Infernus because I recently purchased one, so I decided to go on a ride to the golf course up the street when some noob tried to steal my car. Stupid fuck. Right down the street, I crashed into a fence across the street from my girlfriend's house. I pulled up and finally I told her to come outside. She took like 5 seconds. Stupid bitch. So we started to head to the golf course. We had a casual talk, you know. And there we saw some friends. There was something really weird. When I went by the golf course, there was this one man. His name was a King Lurch, and he pointed at me and he glared at me very badly when I drove by him. It kind of worried me and had me a hazy feeling inside, but I just ignored it for some reason. So then me and her get out of the car and we decide to walk behind the building to start making out some. Ooh, look at those thighs, I was thinking. I'm hitting this with a Clock and Bell shirt on. as we stood there, I gave her a kiss, and she kissed me back. This is a very sad moment in my life. It was the last day I saw my beautiful girlfriend. This maniac right here comes up with guns and shoots her low and rapes her to death. It hurts me inside just watching, and I sat down to cry. I remember sitting down and crying, then he rapes me. It was a horrible day. I'm having a hard time remembering what happened. After the death of my girlfriend, I had to scrape up some cash to pay for her funeral, so I decided to rob the casino. Very good idea. After the casino rob, I decided to go down to the dance club because I was feeling lonely and I needed to get some poon. So I decided to get drunk and dance with this hottie on the dance floor.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. No more. Yeah! don't hurt me no more.
All of a sudden, I wake up in a place I do not know. It's a bathroom, I can see. I'm in a bathtub and my stomach hurts. I lift my shirt and I see that my kidney is gone. Holy shit! That bitch drugged me and stole my fucking kidney, man. Fuck, where am I? Gotta take a piss first, too. Gotta go outside and figure this out. Holy shit, I'm in a small town of Angel Pine outside of San Fierno. Holy shit, I'm in a new world. So as I leave the hospital, they tell me that I'm gonna have to pay a fee of $100,000 to fix my kidney operation. Because that fucking whore stole my fucking kidney at the hotel in Angel Pine. It's not a nice thing to do to a human. But as I just need to like pull over and think of what to rob, because I need some money real quick. I remember there's a mint to rob. So we get a robbery in progress. And we got my accomplice over there to the right. His name is Battle X Fur. He's like dancing in the hallway, so when the cop comes they can't run through that side, because they always come from that. So far so good. And, like, it's a good robbery. I got it. We're gonna start heading out of here. Because I got some money in the safe right now, you know? So, we just gotta get out of here so I can get my kidney operation going down, you know?
Boom, 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 boom.
Now tell me what you gonna do.
But it ain't nowhere to run.
When judgment comes for you.
When judgment comes for you.
Tell me what you gonna do.
But it ain't nowhere to hide.
When judgment comes for you.
Cause it's gonna come
for
you.
It's all swinging in for water. Easy seems so for Charlie. Little group of guys got him. And I'm gonna miss everybody out of road.
Another plan to heaven. Follow the Lord all 24/7 days. God is who we praise. Even though the devil's all up in my face, but he's keeping me safe and in my place. Say grace to the gates of race. Without a change to face the judge. And it gets my soul with books. Grudge me, cause there's no mercy for dust. Ooh, what can I do? It's all about the family and how we grow. Can I get a witness? Let it unfold. We're living our lives to eternal our soul. Hell, hell.
Now follow me, Rosto. Weather is tell her it's tapping. Come, let's go take a visit to the people that's long gone there.
While he's there, Terry Boo.
Instead of keeping up with family, exactly how many days we got lasting? While you laughing, we're passing the way.
So you raise your toes, cause I know I'ma meet you up at the crossroad. Y'all know if I ever got love with them both thugs, baby.
Let me be
long gone, really wish we'd come home. But when it's time to die, gotta go bye-bye. All the little thug could do was cry. Kill my dog. Yeah, man, I miss my Uncle Charles, y'all. And he shouldn't be gone in front of his home. When they did, the root was wrong. Who's the wrong? Who's the wrong? Gotta hold on, gotta stay strong. When it did come, better believe on. Gotta show that you can lean on. Lean on.
Now it's time to get my new kidney from the hospital for $100,000. Yes, new kidney. Now we go. now it's time to go to some illegal street racing to make some fast cash and easy.
Perfect, just enough.
Oh yeah, it ain't over, motherfuckers.
These niggas don't understand. Every few years, niggas got to get their motherfucking caps peeled back. Nigga, this West Side, nigga. Don't think, nigga, don't think. Now, next motherfuckers. Go by the name of Cypress Hill. K.O. motherfucking day. Every few years, niggas think they can deal with the real. Now I got the fuck Cypress Hill. I got a voice you should fear. I drink a beer, bust a rapping in your fucking career. You fucking cowards. Never seen a hood high powered like the West Side Connect. Slide me my tech. I got them. Soon as I spot them, I'm jumping. Gotta treat these bitch ass niggas like they stole something. I see a joint in your clutch. You're smoking that shit too much. Bitch ass touch. Sin that you can't rap from the guts. And me real sounding
show this white boy what that West Side connect like. Booyah, booyah, from the gauge as I spit him. The buckshot spray made him late as I hit him. Ain't got the sweatest punk ass no more. One down and two to go, hit me a 4-4. Let me get my ride on, get my homicide on. Be real with she can be me, cause they know it can't see me, bitch. You should've knew you couldn't fade a real hole. Breathing Inglewood smoke, cause I'm a real soul. You busters wanna see me, but you can't come close. Because I'm ace homies with America's most. Nigga miss me, I'm used to a hoe trying to kiss me. Now what gave your bitch ass enough heart to diss me? To come a missing and sin dog is so wacky, ain't worth dissing. You niggas need to listen. On everything I love, my heat, Capitalese a dove. Fuck rapping, fuck scrapping, I create another bloody glove. It's one note, and for sure I kill. You pussies can't match my skill, cause I'm the king of the heat.
Everybody in the ghetto know what you're doing. One white boy and two fucking Cubans. Mexican, listen to no Vaseline before you flex again. Fucking with the hogs, you say you bloods,
but you ain't like what a dog, fool.
On tour, only rapping to the yuppies. We the big fish and make a dish out your fucking guppies. So who are y'all with? Niggas down with Cypress can wipe this shit off my dick. As I stick it like King Kong and play ping pong with this fake ass Cheech and Chong. Did you tell your mama that I had to help you when Sin Dog left your bitch ass in Australia? You say that I took your hook. It must be the white boy thinking all niggas crooks. Yeah. Now what? You hip hop hippies? How you fucking junkies? Think you gon' punk me and chill and deal with the fact that you ain't got enough skill to kill the king of the hill?
Ice Cube, could you pass me my steel?
For real,
I'm the king of the hill.
Mac King, could you pass?
And this is where I skip out on giving him my pink slip for my bike. Fucking fool thought he was going to get paid. Fuck that shit, I got his car last race, now I'm leaving with my bike and his car. Fucker. This is one of the last times I've seen San Fierno. I just got off of work and I was on my way to the bank. As I went into the bank, I just felt like, sweet, I'm gonna go home and have sex with some hookers, most likely. Cause that's what I do when I get off work, you know? But instead of that, for some reason, two men came into the bank and jumped me for the pink slip that I did not give to the motorcycle winner. Oh my god, I can't even believe it. The next thing you know, I wake up on a boat, the pirate ship, in the middle of nowhere, with four pirates aboard that I could see. And I see a couple weapons lying around me, so I'm gonna grab some. And there's the money they stole from me, but there's no need for that till after I leave. Yes, we got one pirate down so far, almost. Two pirates. We move on to the next pirates, because they're punk-ass pussies that take me out here just because of a pink slip. That's fucked up. They all die for paying, doing this to such a person like me. I've only done good in this world to everyone that I know. Here's my homie Battle Exfer. He's coming up to save me. He got a belt ready for us. Now to the captain of the ship. Oh shit, he's shooting me. How old am I gonna make it? Oh shit. Almost done here with this guy. He's a little harder than the other guys. He is the captain. Oh, he's giving up. He's giving up. That means we're gonna have to go up there, shoot him low life, and pull a pistol at his head. Take him out, dishonorably of his ranks. A Very nice. Now that we killed all the pirates that kidnapped me, we can go to town and start a new life. But first I'm gonna need some money. Most likely a bank heist. Holy shit, that boulder is cold. Oh my god, my balls are shriveling as we speak and I'm trying to get on this boat to get dry. Holy shit. All I remember right here was that I made it and I just needed to lay down and take a break because my body was very cold, so I needed to huddle on the floor to gather warmth so I didn't get hypothermia. Oh, it was a nice ride to the land. This is all I could remember.
I paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shadow and kicks in my face, but I've come through.
And I need to go on, 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 on.
We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end.
We are the champions. We
and everything that goes with it, I thank you all. But it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the whole human race, and I ain't gonna lose.
We are
the champions.
Alright, now we're at the bank robbing it because I needed some quick change, you know? And I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a good day and it's gonna go all good. Just to make sure, just watch my back. So far, no one's coming in. Oh shit, the bitch shot me, what the fuck? I didn't do nothing to her. Alright, and here's my friend Battle Xfer in the Wienermobile. Then we have another one coming up in a semi truck to block any cops. Very good distraction. Then she bought some coffee for me, I remember, and I just started to shoot her because she kept trying to shoot me for some reason. It's like, I'm robbing the bank, bitch. It's not cool what you're doing. It's ruining my money making because I'm very poor. I just got kidnapped by pirates, you stupid bitch. But she doesn't know that, but that's what I think. But it's cool. Alright, we're almost there. It was a short robbery. It was real close to for some reason. I don't know why, but it was. But it's nice to be close, you know, because it's just like, it's convenient. It's like I just drive up the road and here's some cash for me. I can get my life started here again. Maybe one day move back to Los Angeles, who knows. But it's, if that ever happens, it will be a good day for me. Very good day. Alright, so it's just another day in the clucking bells, just waiting to get off work. Oh, three fellas coming, what do they want for to eat? I just remember just sitting there just looking at them, they all had a weird look on their face. And they all, for some reason, were smirking when they bought their food, and when they sat down, I remember hearing them saying something about the chicken shit behind the counter, but at first I thought, maybe I'm just crazy, but maybe they are talking about me, but I've been behind this grill all day, I've been hearing things. Maybe these flies are talking to me or something, who knows. It's hard to tell when you're in a grill with flies buzzing at your ear, you got grease popping, you got hamburger sizzling. It's all good. It looks like they're leaving anyways. He's throwing his trash away or something. Yeah, they're all on the way out. I guess I'm just hearing things. Finally, I was getting off of work at the clucking bells, so I flipped a couple more burgers, cleaned the greasers. Then I headed out for the day. Fuck this counter, I remember it was so hard to get over. There we go. Alright, but I remember that day. I was walking outside, then I see two men across the street that were here earlier eating food. I just kept walking to my bike over there around the corner, and then some man ran around the corner. Oh fuck, he has an AK, I remember saying. Then I remember some angel started beating me up, and some other dude, they just started jumping me. It was a horrible thing. It hurt so much, I broke my ribs that day. But it is all cool because it was all for a reason, and you will see soon. After that brutal beating I just got, I got pistol whipped in the face with the AK. Then they told me I was in the gang. Very good day. Now this cop had to die because he witnessed me getting jumped into the gang, and they needed me to show that I was loyal to them, so I told them that I would kill them. It was a very easy kill. I just remember easily killing him, then this fool on the motorcycle bike trying to come up and say shit to us. So we all whipped out our AKs and just started blasting at his bike. Then we had this car come up with the other gang in Los Santos that was trying to take our turf, so we had to show them up and shoot their car out and have them leave. It was fairly easy. One of them jumped out of the car up there thinking he was going to be able to do something, but I whipped my sniper rifle out and high calibrated his ass, you know? Boom, boom, straight up just dead. It was a beautiful kill, I'd have to say. Clean shot to his cranium, you know, just straight in his dome. It was a fairly good kill, I'd have to say. Now we're just gonna get back to cruising up the road, you know? Alright, I purchased some more AK ammo because I need it. I remember this fool trying to come up constantly and kept getting his ass owned by our weapons because he's in a car. What a fucking idiot. Cars blow up easily. You pop their tires, they fucking swerve. I mean, come on, man. Oh, it's NTZ. It's one of our friends from the gang. It's got a scrambled. We gotta get back to the gang hideout, you know? We got to go organize some crimes in this town. We don't drive helicopters, we go by foot or car. We just gotta wait for him to get out, he's kinda foolish. It's that fucking idiot again, he thinks he's gonna fucking kill us or something. It's all good though. Still got my homies with me. I could purchase some body armor. Cause one of the men in the gang sell weapons to us because what would we do without guns, you know? Alright, and after this I just remember we just went back to the house so we Alright, so me and the new homies needed new money for lowriders, guns, hookers, and everything else needed to make a living in Los Santos. So we decided to come to the city hall to rob Mayor Adam West. Because we just got information that he just got a shipment of new $100 bills. So a plan was to walk into each single room and kill each person individually, one person per room. This was a pretty badass day for us, I'd have to say. It's when our gang was just going to start prevailing in this world. In the next room there was two men in here. They got brutally AK'd down, but that's the most efficient weapon there is. But the next room they were sitting there with their heads up. I don't know why they would do such a thing. At this room, me and my accomplice, Lazzy, went into the room with the last two remaining besides the mayor, and just both shot him down, just executional style or something. I'd have to say those four rooms were brutally murders. And at the mayor, we aim at him, then I remember the bodyguard getting in front. It's like, fool, you could have lived. And then I get the money from the mayor because it's all on the table, then just chainsaw his ass to death. And that's when we leave because we got the money. Yes, this is a successful rob for our gang. We're going to be known in the streets of Los Santos. It's a very nice day for us today. Our gang, we're probably going to go get some hookers. Because, I don't know. At this point, everything was going just as planned, so we're all going to go get it in our cars. Luffy, Lazzy, and Young Gifto all had the money, so they were follow me to our hideout. But as we were leaving, we noticed there was cops on us. They were fucking watching the whole time. It was on camera and shit. But I looked in my rearview mirror and I saw them turn off. Then the cops, they were following me for some reason. They didn't even follow them. So, and then I started to wonder and just, I don't even know.
He who makes a beast out of himself gets rid of the pain of
being a man.
Driving through the night, the heat's so real, weather, the barren empty.
I just looked around and just went to the back of the cell and got down and just put my hands on my head and just screamed loud as I could, because this is where I was going to be for the rest of my life. So this is the story of Rodney Burkoff I told you, so, and it was a pretty interesting one, and it's something I would not have changed at all, except for maybe the jail part, but I'm living good. I rape people and I fuck people up if I have to. It's just a normal jail life. It's just not much else to do except rape people to death and prove yourself, you know? Just making it the next day. But that was the life of a delivery man that was a little crazy in the head. I'm Rodney Burkoff. Hope you have enjoyed my story. Have a good one.